Band of Joy represented an attempt to create, diversify, and celebrate the great dynamics of the music scene of the mid-60s. I just wanted to bring it back into now, you know, to this point in my career.
Good night, sleep tight.
I wanted to bring my personality with other people's songs and kick the door open a little bit, or edge it open with my hips. I sing the way I sing, and to attack those songs, I can only do them plant-like. Angel Dance is very confident and proud. With a lyric like that coming from Los Lobos, it's a major way of opening the door to this particular stage of my very odd left and right career. I approached Buddy Miller because he's like a kind of curator of a rock and roll museum. And with his recommendation, the rhythm section arrived. Throughout the album, the mix and the medicine coming from the bass and the drums is crucial to make these songs live in another place.
You can give me money, diamonds and pearls, but you can't buy my love. No money in the world. You can't buy my love. No, you can't buy my love. For no money in the world.
I was again able to hook up my memory banks with a guy called Bongo Joe, who had an album out on our Hooli in about 1970 called I Wish I Could Sing. And on this compilation was this fantastic Barbara Lynn track, which was the response to Lennon and McCartney's Can't Buy Me Love. And it was just so cute. It was like a pop song. So I just pushed in a little kind of ooh-ooh bridge. It's just comes out of a cupboard that your uncle might have closed up in 1963, really. You open the door and it comes roaring out.
Oh, you can't buy my love. You know you can't buy my love. All the money in the world. You can't buy my love. Oh.
The different experiences I've had along the way in the last few years have led me more and more into the kind of Nashville library of knowledge and technique. It's there to be drawn out. I was thinking about Zeppelin III. I was thinking about the mixture of acoustic and powerful electric. Falling in Love Again, it's originally a great black ballad with all the trappings of 1964. An absolutely spellbinding piece of black pop. The thing that it does probably best of all is it brings in other voices. I really wanted this record to be a band of joy. I wanted to hear voices all around my voice. But if you go back throughout my career, there weren't enough tracks on the tape, or there wasn't enough time in between one insane misreading of history and the next one to bother about backing vocals. It was of very little use in Led Zeppelin, really. Yeah. But for that kind of song, to have that really deep baritone, it's really great as a part of the character of the record.
I hope you don't break my heart.
The things that I found along the way that I didn't expect is the big vocal sounds around the place. Returning to my way of singing as a solo singer.
Yes, I'm falling in love again. Oh. Mm.
mood and lilt and through the years swagger and some sort of physicality through the music has been really quite important to me to get it beyond the words. Times as the record progressed when we needed a really high salutation, a voice that soared above it all and brought home integral parts of the songs. Buddy had just been producing the most recent album for Patty Griffin, the Church album. It seemed perfect because she was so free and easy about approaching Monkey and Silver Rider, where it kind of needed a real vocal approach in an area where I haven't heard her sing before. Enigma and story of Townes Van Zandt continues to open more and more to me on a daily basis. His whole vision of compromise by just the daily grind about what you have to do to get through was spectacular, and the sensitivity and also the futility of it, you know. Does it really matter? Do we take it all in? Unbearable yet my name. All me, all my. The song Palm Swift Way, I heard the version that Townes recorded. The lyric is dumbfounding. It just wipes you out completely. Very mournful and very dirge-like, and I just thought, well, there may be another way of doing this. Maybe we can turn it into something that actually is not a monument to him, but just another reflection of his work. Oh me, oh my, who's gonna mark my time? Central 209, it's like, hello Central, give me 209, I'll try to find my baby, she's somewhere on the line. Lightning Hopkins meets Sun House, and it was again visiting so many amazing songs that changed my life. I'm wrapping them all up in one piece. In a way, I mean, Led Zeppelin 3 is not too far away from the way I was looking at this as a group of songs and as an attitude. To combine electric power with an acoustic mesh. Just call up Central 209. Get my baby on the line. I'm still absolutely bowled over by the surprises and shocks that music can give you. There's no point in older musicians like myself saying, it's not like it used to be, it ain't so good anymore, because it is. You just gotta go find it. When I was 17, I was playing everybody else's stuff and moving it around. And it's kind of in a way, while I saw this as being time to reinvoke that, basically, I just wanna sing.